Alright, just got done training. About to head to someplace to have lunch with the media. So it was cool meeting with the media before the fight and just kind of talking about the fight, hyping it up and some repetitive questions and stuff, but it's always a good time when you run into the journalists you appreciate and everything. So just gonna go do that. I think it might be more local stuff, so you know, sometimes these things are a little, there's a couple of people, sometimes there's one or two people, or sometimes there's whatever, but yeah, just fulfilling my UFC obligations.
Does it get you excited when this stuff starts to roll around, because you're drawing near, closer to the fight?
Yeah, it's all timing with everything, you know, but luckily I got my workout in, so I feel like in a good spirit going out there, but if I didn't get my workout in, I'd probably be a little edgy and just ready to get out of there and stuff, so it's all timing with these things, but yeah, I do love, you know, I like that it's here, you get that nervous chill, but you're also just pumped that it's like, it's finally here, you know what I mean?
You talked about repetitive questions. What would you want reporters to ask you at this point?
You know, asking me at this point, you know, I don't know. That's kind of like their job, you know what I mean? You know, but I know what I don't want them to ask me, you know what I mean, you know?
What's that?
I don't know. They always ask, oh, well, what do you think about Eddie Alvarez's shit-talking comments, you know? Or, you know, they try to get into, like, more gossip than just, like, the techniques of the fight and the matchups and everything. So I know that. But, you know, I like some real intelligent questions about the sport, about the martial arts, and maybe about positioning and, you know, some of the judging in the sport. Just like, you know, I'm a geek when it comes to martial arts. You know, that's what I want to talk about more. And sometimes it gets a little more complex, I guess.
I wanted to ask you, too, what do you think some rule changes could be made to benefit the sport right now?
I think one good thing would be, like, some real rules to, like, follow along with, you know? Like, maybe a referee is, like, giving some sort of points, you know, giving some sort of advantages and some catches, you know, because there's some like close submissions and, you know, who, and if they can kind of distinguish who's on offense and who's defense, you know, and show people, then people can follow along and know someone's winning, you know, someone could be winning from the bottom and people don't know, they just think they're on the bottom and they're losing, you know, and I think there's ways that a referee can show that the person on bottom is in control, or it's a neutral position, or someone is, you know, or the other person on top is in control. You know, there's riding time in wrestling, there's kind of positions like that, and a punch has landed, yeah, you know, is it a power punch, or, you know, there's so many things, you know, but something where everyone can follow along, and you can know if you're ahead, you know, maybe you know you're behind, you know?
On a scale from 1 to 10, how educated would you say the judges in MMA are today?
You know, it's hard to say. You know, it's hard to say because I've never really been able to sit down and talk with them. But I've seen some big mistakes in some fights before, you know, and I'm puzzled why someone won or someone lost. And but it seems to happen in boxing as well, so I don't know.
What are some recent fights that have really shocked you when it comes to the decision? Can you remember off the top of your head?
Well, the biggest shock, you know, I love Bisping and stuff, but I know he fought Matt Hamill a long time ago in, like, the UK, dude, and Matt Hamill totally won that fight, you know? But, you know, if they ran it back, I think Bisping would definitely, you know, take that now. But I remember that one was pretty, it's pretty weird. And, of course, you know, it's just depending on how you're scoring a fight, is, you know, they're inconsistent with the aggressor being the winner or the elusive fighter being the winner, you know? I don't know. Sometimes it gets a little confusing. You know, there's no real blueprint to follow, you know? So it's inconsistent. So if there's something we could always follow and know if you're walking forward, you're winning, or knowing that walking forward will not make you win and being elusive is more effective and scoring points on the outside, you know?
You and Cowboy Cerrone both fought Ben Henderson.
Mm-hmm.
He got the nod. You didn't. A lot of people thought that he shouldn't have got the nod, and you should have. How did you feel about that fight? And when you look back at the fight, what do you take from it?
Yeah, I look back on that fight, and you know, I know what I would do different, or you know, or as a fighter, you know, or how I would prepare a little different and stuff. But I did feel like I won. I feel like I was a little more aggressive, you know, and trying to push the fight. You can only push so much before compromising your position or compromising, you know, the whole match because of one takedown is scored on you. You bounce back up, but then he's elusive again and you're down because you're doing by 1 point. So you can only put so much pressure before compromising that. But yeah, I thought I was the aggressor, but you know, he's the champ. I see how it goes. You know, you just kind of I blame myself more than anyone else that, you know, I should have, you know, should have pushed a little harder, should have just kind of took that gamble a little bit more. But I honestly, in the fifth round, I really tried, dude. I feel like if you watch that fight again, like I'm literally chasing the guy, you know, literally chasing the guy, you know, and it was still a close round, you know, but I was so just like trying to fight and, you know, and I, and, so it's weird, you know.
People say it's only a loss if you don't learn from it. Do you feel that way?
Sure, you know, it's about the journey, you know what I mean? It's how you like go out in this sport, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, all the greats have lost and come back though, you know, and you know, it'd be suck to just, you know, keep losing and losing and losing, you know, so I still got a lot of fight in me and, you know, and this is what makes stories better, you know, overcoming adversity and coming back, but yes, you gotta learn from the losses, dude, and I feel like I have from this one, you know, I definitely have, you know.